Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'm going to talk to you today about the root causes of iodine deficiency. This is the last video I'm going to be doing on iodine. So if you have more questions, please put them down in the comment section so that we can get a dialogue going. I'm so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knutson, and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female-related issues using food as medicine. So be sure to hit the subscribe button and don't forget to click that notification bell so you never miss an episode. So in my last video, we talked about how much iodine you should take as a woman. If you missed that video, the link is in the description box below. Go ahead and watch it, but make sure you come back to this one. But today we're going to talk about the causes of iodine deficiency, but we're going to get to the root cause of why it even exists in the first place. First of all, I want you to know that it is possible to overcome deficiencies. I know a lot of you have been struggling with deficiencies for years upon years upon years, especially like the vitamin D and the anemia. And some of you have been struggling with iodine deficiency and didn't even know it. But you can overcome. I am a living testament that you can overcome vitamin and mineral deficiencies because I was so deficient in so many areas that I don't even know how my body was even able to function. And a lot of you are going through that same thing. So I want to encourage you, you can overcome these deficiencies. So if you go back on my channel, probably in around the 2015 timeframe, you can go back and look at some of the deficiencies that I was struggling with. I was an absolute mess, okay? I think that if I hadn't turned that stuff around by, you know, making changes in my life, I don't know that you and I would be having this conversation right now. I'm so grateful that things have changed. I have lots of energy. I don't suffer from all of those deficiencies, and I want to teach you how to do the same thing. So what I have learned in this whole process is that toxicity is the root cause of deficiency. Let me say that again. Toxicity is the root cause of deficiency. And it doesn't matter what the deficiency is. It could be iron deficiency, vitamin D deficiency, iodine deficiency. It doesn't matter. Toxicity is at the root. So here's what I mean by that. If your organs and glands that are responsible for making sure your body is functioning properly are clogged up, toxic, with debris from foods that we have eaten that we had no business putting in our body because it's not even real food, from skin products that we put on our skin, from makeup that we put on, from things we wash our clothes with, our body gets overloaded with toxicity. So when it's overloaded with toxicity, it can't function the way it's supposed to smoothly so that it can, one, extract the nutrients from foods that we are eating. And if we're not even eating foods that have nutrition in it, and most Americans don't, that most of the time there is not a piece of lettuce that runs past a person's mouth, or if it is, it's doused in all kinds of chemical laden salad dressings that are from the store shelves that our body doesn't even know what to do with any of that stuff. So how is it that it's able to even dissect the nutrients from the food? It can't. So toxins build up and in our bodies clog up our organs, make them not work optimally, and we expect to have the vitamins and nutrients in our bodies to function normally. We can't. And also what ends up happening is when, so for example, if you're someone who is anemic, for example, if your body is toxic, when you have your monthly cycle, your body's trying to flush out all the toxins. That is one reason that women have heavy bleeding. So if they're trying to flush out all the toxins in the blood, you're losing your necessary iron that you need for your everyday living. And if you're all you're eating is junk food, you're not even doing what you need to replace it. And then if you take a supplement, the supplement isn't even being broken down because your body's too toxic to break it down. Does that make sense? So we need our organs and glands detoxified so that it can assimilate the nutrients in the food that we give it. And if we're going to take a supplement, our bodies need to be in a position to even break down the supplement. Also, the supplement needs to be a good quality supplement so that we can even use what the supplement is giving us. If we're taking supplements that are inferior or not good or made up of junk, the only option that we have is putting more junk in. We're not even getting what we think we're getting. So you have to be careful which supplements you're actually taking. And that's another thing. That's why I just don't throw supplements out there, because I only believe in, if you're going to take supplements, I only believe in taking good quality ones. If they're not good quality, just don't even waste your money, because they're not even going to help you. And good quality doesn't always mean the most expensive, but sometimes it does, because it takes money to actually put these products together so that they can do what you want them to do. I didn't really mean to get off onto this tangent, but I just want to drive the point home. If you are living a lifestyle where you're eating like all kinds of garbage and you're not putting a lot of good nutrition in your body, then that's why you're deficient. If you think you're eating healthy, please reevaluate it if you are suffering with these deficiencies, because it is very possible that if you're doing everything you can to eat well, that your diet may not be as pristine as you think it is. Or whatever supplements you're taking might not be the very good supplements that is giving your body what it actually needs to come out of deficiency. The other thing that you have to look at is cleansing your body, like cleansing your organs, cleansing your colon, and cleansing your liver and your kidneys, and cleansing your cells at a cellular level, like your tissues of your body at a cellular level, to get rid of all the years of toxicity that has built up in your body so that your body can actually work the way it's supposed to work. It's like if you put gas in your gas tank and then you put some sand in your tank and mixed it with the gas, and you try to run down the street, your car's probably going to be jerking, doing all this, not even able to function properly. That's the same thing with our bodies. If we put food in our body and that food is not real food, food as close to the way God made it as possible, fresh fruits and vegetables, nuts and seeds, especially if you're trying to heal naturally from a female reproductive issue, you really want to stay away from animal products and sugar and processed foods. If you feed your body with those healthy foods, and there's plenty of recipes on my channel for you to take a look at. If you feed your body with those healthy foods, your body will slowly come out of toxicity. There are things you can do to make the detox process go faster. I talk about the levels of detoxification in my group coaching programs and my one-on-one coaching program, so you can learn how to go deeper into detoxification versus doing a slower detox. So we got to get our bodies clean, get our organs clean so they can work efficiently. Now, I did a video a while ago, probably maybe like 2 or 3 months ago or something like that, that said, like, it's called How Do You Know If Your Body Is Toxic? And I will link that video above, and I will also put it in the description box below. But some ways that you can know that you are toxic is if you have vitamin mineral deficiency, if you have any type of female reproductive issue, if you're having heavy bleeding, if you have an achy body, joint pain, if you have foggy thinking, if your skin is a mess, you have acne, you know, like the list goes on. If you have dandruff, if your hair is falling out, those are signs that you are toxic. And if you have those things, you need to address them, because in order to heal, you've got to get rid of the toxicity in your body. And I am going to be doing more videos on how to detoxify your body, what detoxification is, and what it really means to detox. Because most people, when they hear the word detox, they think of, oh, I'm just gonna go on a juice cleanse for 3 days, or I'm gonna go on this smoothie cleanse for 15 days. Let me just tell you right now, 15 days, 10 days is not enough to detox all of the myriad of toxins that have bombarded our life from birth. It's not. So detoxification is an ongoing process. Sometimes we detox deep, sometimes we don't detox as deep. It depends on where we are in our process. But I'm going to drive this point home again. If you want to overcome vitamin and mineral deficiencies, you have to detoxify your body. And 30 days isn't even enough to detox your body. I'm telling you, you have to live a detox lifestyle. Also, I would love to hear from you if you are fighting symptoms of toxicity or of iodine deficiency, and you have been doing the work to try to overcome and you still are not having any relief, please comment below. I would love to hear from you. Also, I work with people all the time who are struggling with this, and I show you step by step on how to detoxify your body. So if you want to talk to me, you can click the link below and schedule a free 10-minute strategy session to see if working together is going to be a fit for the both of us. Also, in my next video, I will be sharing with you one of my most favorite detoxification juice recipes if you want to start the detox process. That video will be next. And also, if in general you just want to start juicing, I do have a juice recipe book that is specifically for women's health. And juicing is a perfect way to start detoxifying your body because it washes the nasties out of your cells. I mean, that's how I look at juicing. Juicing is fabulous. If this video has helped you in any way, please comment below. But if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Don't forget to subscribe. And until next time, y'all, take care. Much love.